another session on operations research. In this session, we are going to take up few more numericals on the topic of mathematical formulation of linear programming problem. A manufacturer intends to market a new fertilizer produced from a mixture of two ingredients A and B. So the first data given to us is the ingredients of the fertilizer mix that is being made. This is a problem itself of fertilizer mix. So ingredients A and B. The compositions of the two ingredients are as follows. So you can see bone metal is 20% in ingredient A and 40% in B. Similarly, the percentages of nitrogen, lime and phosphate are given. The management decision is that the fertilizer must be sold in bags of 20 kg, must contain at least 25% bone metal, so it is 25% here, must contain at least 15% nitrogen and must contain at least 10% of phosphate. The cost of ingredients is rupees 20 per kg for A and rupees 16 per kg for B. So here we are talking about the cost. Write the LP formulation for the quantities of the ingredients to be mixed to minimize the material cost. So very clearly you can see that the problem is of minimization type. I'll first select the decision variables. Let X1 be the quantity of ingredient A in the bag of 20 kg and X2 is the quantity of ingredient B in the bag of 20 kg. After this, we will write the objective function. We are trying to minimize said. So as you see, it is given that it is rupees 20 per kg for A and rupees 16 per kg for B. So I'll write down it is 20 x1 plus 16 x2. Next, I'll write down the constraints. So it is subject to certain constraints. The first one that you can see is the summation of these two ingredients will lead to 20 kgs bag. So I'll write here x1 plus x2 is equal to 20. Next, it's given that it must contain at least 25% of bone metal. Now we are talking about 25% of the 20 kg. So this is going to be 5 kg. And here if you see bone metal is 20% and 40%. So I'll write here 0.2x1 plus 0.4x2 will be greater than or equal to 5 because it is written it is at least. Same way it must contain at least 15% of nitrogen. So when you multiply with 20, this becomes 3 kgs. So again this will be 0.3x1 plus 0.15. 0.3x1 plus 0.15x2 at least, so greater than or equal to 3. And for the last one it is written must contain at least 10% of phosphate. So this will be 10% of 20, that is 2 kg. So 10 and 5 is given. So this will be 0.1x1 plus 0.05x2 greater than or equal to 2. And last non-negativity constraint is x1 and x2 are greater than or equal to 0. So that's how you formulate this LPP. Next, let's take up another problem. This is a problem on alloy mix. A research laboratory has two melts of copper nickel alloy to make up a new alloy. The composition of metals is as under melt 1 and 2. So you can see here the composition for copper 2 and 1 and nickel 1 and 1 is given. To make up the new alloy, at least 10 kgs of copper and 6 kgs of nickel is needed. Now copper, as you see, is in the ratio of 2:1. So this is 2 out of 3 and 1 out of 3. This is in the ratio of 1:1. So this is 1 by 2 and 1 by 2, the presence. melt 1 costs rupees 25 per kg while 2 costs rupees 30 per kg. Write the LP model for the quantities of each melt to be used to minimize the cost. So it is already mentioned very clearly that we are trying to minimize the cost. First, we will take up the decision variables. Let x1 is the quantity in parts of melt 1 and x2 is the quantity in parts of melt 2. Next, we'll talk about the objective function. We are trying to minimize Z. You can see the price for melt 1 is rupees 25. So it is 25 X1 plus 30 X2. Next, we'll talk about the constraints. So you can write down subject 2 or the constraints that we have. The first constraint over here is of copper. So at least 10 kgs of copper is there. So you can see it is in the ratio of 2/3 X1 plus nickel is 1/2 X2 greater than equal to 10, at least 10 kg. And again 6 kgs of nickel is needed. So here we are going to place 1/3 X1 plus half X2 from here, 1/3 and half. This is greater than equal to 6. And last, we know X1, X2 will be greater than equal to 0. So that's the only part of the problem given. Let's take up another numerical. A kitchen manager at ABC Hospital has to decide the food mix for the patients. Dietary instructions are that each patient must get at least 1 gram of protein, 1 gram of fat, 3 grams of carbohydrates. Additional instructions are that in no case the carbohydrate content should exceed 6 grams per patient. The availability of proteins, fat and carbohydrates in grams per kg of chicken, rice and bread is as given below. So you can see here for chicken, bread and rice, the protein content is given, fat content, carbohydrate and the price is given. Formulate a suitable mathematical model for the above diet mix assuming 100 patients on that day in order to minimize the cost. This problem is of diet mix type. What mix you will make of diet for the patients in the hospital? So first we will talk about the decision variables. Let X1 is the quantity in kg of chicken to be used. X2 is quantity in kg of rice to be used. And X3 is the quantity in kg of bread to be used. Since the price is mentioned, when we talk about minimizing cost, we will write 30x1 plus 5x2 plus 4x3. So I'll write the objective function. Minimize Z. 30x1 plus 5x2 plus 4x3. Next, we'll talk about the constraints. It is very easy. When we are talking about protein, you can see it is 10x1 plus 2x2 plus 2x3, and this should be at least 1 gram of protein, and there are 100 patients. So 100 patients will require 100 grams. So this will be greater than equal to 100. When we talk about fat, it should be again 1 gram of fat for each patient. So this value will also be greater than equal to 100. 3 grams of carbohydrate, again at least. So here we'll write greater than equal to 300. But if you read, there is another constraint given that it should not exceed 6 grams. So this should also be less than equal to 600. So these are the 4 constraints given. So let us write them down. 10x1 plus 2x2 plus 2x3 greater than equal to 100. Then we have for fat 2x1 plus x2 greater than equal to 100. For carbohydrate we have 15x2 plus 10x3 greater than equal to 300. And we have 15x2 plus 10x3 less than equal to 600. The non-negativity constraints are x1, x2, x3 greater than equal to 0. So with this, I end the session. I hope you have understood how to formulate the LPP. If you have any doubts, please write to me in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon for latest video updates. See you in the next session. Thank you.